Hey, what's up guys? Welcome back to Jiu-Jitsu Flow. This is a channel where we're doing workouts based on jiu-jitsu and grappling movements and techniques. This is gonna be a mobility routine. No equipment or partners required. It's gonna be all follow along. If you like the channel, please like and subscribe. I really appreciate the support. If you wanna follow for more solo movements, you can check out my Instagram and TikTok account as well, okay? Let's get into the routine and hope you guys enjoy. All right, guys, we're gonna get started with hollow body rolls. Great movement just to help loosen up our spine. Key points, we wanna keep our knees tucked to our chest as we roll, chin tucked to our chest as well. This movement, it's great to help loosen up the spine, but also is really important from the seated guard position, okay? This is a movement that will help when we're in a butterfly guard and we're looking to pull our opponent into different ashigarami attacks, as well as butterfly sweeps. We just wanna be able to get used to that concave spine and being able to keep our knees in the chest, which helps us start to elevate our opponents. All right, let's go, 10 seconds. Three, two, one, and rest. Good, next movement is gonna be a pendulum roll. So we're gonna do the same thing, but one leg at a time. Here we go, let's go right leg first. We'll go for 30 seconds and then we'll switch sides. If you can't touch your foot all the way over your head onto the floor, that's okay, but that is the goal. And then when we roll forward, we're using our pendulum leg, which is a straight leg, to drive the heel down to the floor. Gives us momentum as we come up. Okay, 30 seconds, we're gonna switch legs. And switch. Now our left leg will become our pendulum leg. The opposite leg, we're still keeping our knee to our chest. Don't forget to breathe. Ten seconds. In three, two, one, and rest. Good. Okay, we're now gonna go into leg pummeling and neck rotations at the same time, working on our body coordination. Okay, first 20 seconds, we're gonna circle our legs to the right and we're gonna do looking to the right and left. Chin is touching each shoulder. At 40 seconds, we're gonna switch directions with our legs. Here we go. And switch. Now we're pummeling to the left and we're going ear to shoulder, looking up at the ceiling. Final 20 seconds, keep going, final 20 seconds. We're gonna windshield wipe our knees and do yeses, chin to chest. Here we go, last 20 seconds. Windshield wiping our knees, our legs, chin to chest. Working on the body coordination, putting everything together. Three, two, one, and rest, good. Okay, let's sit up. Now we're gonna go into three-way hip mobility from the seated guard. First set will be dropping the knees. This will be for 20 seconds. We wanna start with our feet shoulder width apart. Our inside leg should be touching the floor. Good, now we're gonna lean over our shin, starting at the knee, going all the way to the foot and back, keeping our chest over our shin, getting a little deeper stretch. Last 20 seconds, we're gonna come up onto our shin. Here we go, last 20 seconds, we're coming all the way up. We can use our hands to help support us through the transition from side to side. Good. And 3, 2, 1, rest. Nice. Now we're going to go into a knee in elbow escape. So we're on our back. 3, 2, 1. Here we go. So 3-point frame with our arms. We're going to drop our right knee. We're going to the right side. We're going to do an asymmetric bridge. This is going to get our opponent off balance, which allows us to bring our knee inside their legs to our chest. And this type of elbow escape is great to go into an offensive attack, usually some form of ashigarami. The 3-point frame with our arms is used to keep our opponent at distance. We don't want them to be able to, when they're in the top mount, to be able to come all the way up and isolate our shoulder or our arms above our shoulders. So this is just another variation of an elbow escape. 10 seconds. Then we're going to switch sides. 3, 2, 1, and rest. Good. All right, let's go to the left side now. 3, 2, 1, and begin. So we're dropping the left knee. And when we do this, we're pushing off on the opposite foot. So this is gonna be everything's coming from the right foot that's creating the power for the asymmetric bridge. Now we're bringing the left knee inside. And our 3-point frame, the 3 points on our arms, we have our left elbow on the ground, we have our hands connecting, which is the second point in opponents in their hip, and then we have our right elbow on the far side that's connected to our opponent's same side hip. That elbow is preventing them from being able to take our back when we do that bridge. 10 seconds. Three, two, one, and rest. Good. Okay, let's come up onto our knees now. We're gonna do a standing to bridge. 3, 2, 1, and go. We'll start on the right side first. So we windshield wipe our knees. We're keeping our upper body facing straight ahead. This is working on standing up when we're in our opponent's closed guard. At 30 seconds, we're gonna switch sides. We wanna maintain a good upper body posture. Good, and let's switch sides now. We're windshield wiping to the left. And when we windshield wipe to the left, we're gonna step down with our left foot. On the right side, you should be stepping down with our right foot. Just to switch up our movements, we wanna have body coordination on both sides. Here we go, 10 seconds. 3, 2, 1, rest, good. Okay, we're now gonna go jumping to base, but we're gonna do it with 2 hands on the floor. All right, 3, 2, 1, here we go. So generally, we're gonna put 2 hands out and we jump to base. In live training, think of we're either grabbing a collar if we're in the gi, feeding it to our opponent's armpits, and then we can walk forward or we can jump to base. Or if it's no gi, we're putting our hands on our opponent's bicep and then being able to jump to base. All right, but it's a great workout, just getting the mobility and body coordination to be able to jump to a strong base. Don't forget to breathe. We're exhaling as we exert energy. 10 seconds, inhaling through our transitions. Here we go, 3, 2, 1, and rest. Good, okay, now we're gonna go into a forward headstand. 3, 2, 1, here we go. So we're starting on our knees. We're gonna go right side first, so we're kicking off our right leg. When we do a headstand, even though it's called a headstand, it's really a forehead stand. We want to have our weight on our forehead, not on the top of our, like the crown of our head. Makes it much harder to balance yourself. So you want to stay on your forehead. All right, at 30 seconds, we're going to switch sides and kick off our left leg. This is helping us when we do the next movement, which is the a forehead pass. We're passing our opponent's guard. Okay, but this is just gonna help you gain control and be comfortable with going onto our forehead. And if you can't go too high right now, that's okay. Just go as high as you can. Maybe even if you're just lifting your foot off the ground, just an inch or two. Just get used to this movement here, being on your forehead. 3, 2, 1, and rest. Good. All right, now we're gonna increase the mobility of it. Okay, and this is what the actual pass is gonna look like when we're with an opponent. So when we kick off our right foot, our head's on the same side, okay? So we're always kicking off that inside leg and our head is on the same side. So we're right here, when we switch our hips in the air, we're transitioning from one side to the other of our opponent. If you want to see this movement when I do it with an opponent or with the grappling dummy, check out my Instagram page so you can get an idea if you're confused at all here. Here we go, 10 seconds. Three, two, one. And rest, good. Okay, let's go back to the seated guard position. We're gonna start with the single leg Koichi. 3, 2, 1, here we go. We'll go left leg first. We're gonna switch sides back and forth. This is a single leg Koichi. When our opponent is standing in front of us, we're looking to scoop one of their feet to off balance them. So many different variations from here. The sequence we're gonna work on or progress to is a single leg Koichi, where we then can stand up and go into an outside single leg. And we're gonna do different movements to put that together. But you should have your hand placement be in control so that you can comfortably shift your body weight forward and back. Here you go, 10 seconds. Three, two, one, and rest, good. Okay, so now we're gonna take it a step further. We're gonna do single leg Koichi into a kneeling position. All right, 3, 2, 1, here we go. So the same leg that does the Koichi is gonna swing back, kind of like a self-defense stand-up or a technical stand-up. Bring it all the way back through to a kneeling position. Or a squatting position. And we're switching sides, going back and forth. Want to have body coordination and control on both sides. We're always going to have a dominant side for the most part, but we want to be comfortable on both sides. Just gives us a significant advantage when we can do things on both sides. Here we go, 10 seconds. Three, two, one, and rest, good. Okay, so now let's break it down. We're gonna start from the kneeling position. We're gonna do an outside single leg, all right? Here we go. So the knee that's up is gonna go down and we switch sides. All right, we're just going back and forth. All right, this is like a outside single, sweeping single leg. The hand that's swinging forward and now while we're practicing as a solo movement is going to the ground, that's the leg that would be grabbing our opponents. You know, usually grabbing at the knee line. But this is a good movement just to get in the habit or get the coordination of going for that outside single. Ten seconds. Three, two, one, and rest. Good. All right, let's put it all together now. So we're gonna do a single leg Koichi to a kneeling stance all the way to an outside single. All right, here we go. Single leg Koichi, bring the leg back, and then we're going to the outside single. The outside single, we're going to the leg where our knee is up. Think about, we off balance our opponent, we get them stepping forward, and then we can go to the leg that is closest to us. This is just one variation, a lot of different options off this single leg Koichi. When we do the outside single, you could use the hand post just to help take a little pressure off your knees. Last few. Three, two, one, and time. Awesome job, guys. Let's finish up with 1 minute of breathing. Here we go, and begins from the seated position. When we do this breath work, we're focusing on exhaling and drawing our belly button in, okay? Start out, if you can exhale every second, that's great. Once that becomes really easy, okay, then you can do 2 exhales every second until you can start increasing it, you know, to where exhaling is as many times as possible in a minute. Okay, but start out being able to exhale every second and then see if you can exhale twice every second. This is how you'll start gaining control of your diaphragm, eventually down the road, being able to start massaging it and really just learning how to control your breath and using it to our advantage. All right, awesome job, guys. Here we go, 3, 2, 1, and time. Really, really good job. Hope you guys enjoyed. Again, please subscribe to the channel, like, share with friends, anyone that would find it helpful, and I'll see you guys next time. Thanks a lot.